Hello and welcome to Walk the Talk. I'm Shekhar Gupta in much maligned Latrians, Delhi. And my guest today, Najma Heptullah, and I will be doing great injustice to her and India's minorities. And Najma ji, if I may say so, India's majority community as well, if I described you just as our minority affairs minister, because you are one of the titans of Indian politics, the senior most member of this cabinet, and a guardian of India's parliament for a very long time. So welcome to Walk the Talk.
Thank you. It's very nice of you to take notice of me, because when I was deputy chairman, I was every day on the television. So I never gave any interview to anybody because they thought they have seen me enough on the TV.
I know, and I remember you all the time chiding members by saying, I'm standing on my feet, please sit down. some people listened, others did not.
Oh, Sen Saab has made a painting for me while I'm standing with my both the hands saying, please sit down.
M.F. Hussain.
M.F. Hussain was a member of the house.
So tell me, how do you see M.F. Hussain? I mean, you've now taken this conversation in a different direction. My other plan, all my plans go for a sixth moment I find a guest like you, who's what?
M.F. Hussain was a great artist and a very good person. And he was a member of Rajya Sabha.
Right.
And he made a whole book on his 6 years in the Rajya Sabha. He was a nominated member. So when you said my hands up, so I only remember my hands up in his portrait.
So Najma ji, now M.F. Hussain, he's a metaphor. Is he, I mean, do you see him as a great representative of India's largest minority? Or do you see him as challenging the notion of minority and majority?
I look at M.F. Hussain as a very good artist and a very good human being. And when they are very good artists, where they are a musician, whether it's Ravi Shankar or M.F. Hussain or Ali Akbar Khan or his father, Alauddin Khan, they were all basic Indian, representative of the Indian ethos.
Aap cabinet mein hai. कैबिनेट का हर डॉक्यूमेंट सीक्रेट होता है. दैट मींस दिस कंट्री ट्रस्ट्स यू विद एवरी सीक्रेट दैट्स वर्थ कीपिंग.
यस,
राइट.
आई होप
यस. सो एवरी मुस्लिम, एवरी सीक्रेट दैट कम्स बिफोर द कैबिनेट, सो एवरी मुस्लिम, एवरी क्रिश्चियन, एवरी जैन, एवरी बडी फ्रॉम एवरी कम्युनिटी वॉन्ट्स टू बी टेकन टू बी ट्रीटेड विद इक्वल ट्रस्ट.
एग्जैक्टली.
वॉज दैट द केस अंडर द कांग्रेस?
आई विल टेल यू व्हाट इज द केस इन द बीजेपी, बिकॉज नाउ आई एम इन द बीजेपी. Now the BJP, what is the BJP's program? We take it for what the promises they make in the manifesto and what the leader of the party, the in this case Narendra Modi ji, as a prime ministerial candidate had committed everywhere or spoken about. Sabka Saath Sabka Vikas was the focus on it. Even when in Patna the bomb were blasting, he did not change his focus on Vikas. He didn't react on what was happening, the bombs are blasting and somebody else was there. He would have run away or he would have changed his speech. He didn't. His focus was on development. He asked the Muslims, what do you want? You want to fight against the Hindu or the poverty? They said poverty. Same thing the Hindus replied, our fight is against poverty, not the Muslim. So his focus on development. Secondly, the other part of it, which is my guide, is the manifesto of the party. And if you look at the 8 points of manifesto, 6 of them are development, which is part of my ministry. The last two which I mentioned, safety, security, anti-inequality and equal status, is the part of the home ministry. Safety, security is home ministry's responsibility, not my ministry's responsibility. So I'm taking care of those 6 issues.
That's why you have not been to Dadri.
Yeah, my job is not, it's the home minister to take care of. And anyway, we are forgetting one thing. Dadri is not in central government. Dadri is a state government. In a federal system, the states are responsible. Agar center kabhi in halat mein kisi mein dakhal deti hai, to mujhe yaad hai parliament ke 17-18 saal mein chair pe rahi, कोई भी अगर स्टेट की बात उठाता था तो कहते थे ये स्टेट का मैटर, यहां लॉ एंड ऑर्डर हमारा.
स्टेट ने रिपोर्ट मांगी है, सेंटर ने रिपोर्ट मांगी है स्टेट से और रिपोर्ट आ गई है.
वो तो रिपोर्ट मांगेंगे, वो रिपोर्ट तो आएगी, मगर सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट के ऊपर जिम्मेदारी जब होती अगर उन्होंने हैंडओवर कर दिया होता। हाँ। अभी तो वो जिम्मेदार है। और मुझे अजीब सी हैरत हो रही है इस बात पे कि जो जिम्मेदार हैं लॉ एंड ऑर्डर के, जो जिम्मेदार हैं लोगों की घरों की, उनके माल की, उनकी हिफाजत करने के लिए, वो यूनाइटेड नेशन जा रहे हैं। अरे अपने गरिमान में तो मुंह डाल के देखो।
जो कह वो यूनाइटेड नेशन जाके लोग कह रहे हैं अपनी भैंसें ढूंढ लेंगे, पहले गुम हो गई थी उनकी।
मुझे मैं सोचती हूँ कि मुझे लग रहा है कि एक सीरियस इशू है, एक लॉ एंड ऑर्डर प्रॉब्लम है।
बुरा तो हुआ,
बुरा हुआ, उसमें कोई दो राय नहीं, मगर उसको इतना पॉलिटिकलाइज करके इस इशू को यूनाइटेड नेशन में लाना, मुझे लगता है वो सीरियसली नहीं।
वो तो बेवकूफ की बात है। मैंने भी उसका खुद भी मजाक उड़ाया है। मैंने कहा कि यूएन जा रहे हैं तो समाजवादी पार्टी के लिए एक परमानेंट मेंबरशिप ऑफ सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल भी ही शुड आस्क फॉर अकॉर्डिंगली। तो लेकिन प्लीड देयर केस।
अभी देखिए मेरे मंत्रालय जो है, जो भी इस तरह के वाकत होते हैं उस पर हम रिएक्ट करते हैं कि हाँ सोचना के लॉ विल टेक इट्स ओन कोर्स, जो भी है रिपोर्ट आई है सरकार पढ़ेगी देखे। मगर इससे मेरा काम तो नहीं रुक जाता है। मेरे मंत्रालय में हम 86 लाख वी गिव स्कॉलरशिप एट डिफरेंट लेवल्स, प्री मैट्रिक, पोस्ट मैट्रिक, मेरिट कमी। 46% ऑफ देम आर गर्ल्स, विच इज़ अ फोकस इन आर मैनिफेस्टो। देन skill development, we do a lot of skill development, and you will be happy to know in Bombay we started the skill development program. And the skill development program, when I was giving the certificates, out of 1500 students or youths, 1400 were girls. So is it not good? It is not in tune what my party's manifesto says.
So should there be, I mean, in 21st century, in 2015, should this country be caught in controversies over the cow or over eating habits? Are we getting distracted?
Shall I tell you something, Shekhar ji, that you reminded me of my childhood. When I talked to you about the second part of the national anthem, I can tell you my childhood memory of 8 years. When I was in school, maybe in fourth or fifth class, there was a Urdu book, Urdu teaching book, which was done by Muhammad Hussain Merathi. He wrote a book in which, you know, we used to learn Urdu from first standard till seventh standard. So in one of the books, there was a poem. It was on Gaye. I know some of the standards by heart till today. Rab ka shukr ada kar bhai, jisne hamari gaye banayi. Us malik ko kyun na pukare, जिसने पिलाई दूध की धारे।
Having known sort of Muslim community and society also from close, by and large Muslims also respect this.
Exactly, and this controversy came with the British.
Of it, cow.
Oh yeah, because cow. Where Islam came, from where the Islam came, there are no cows. There are only sheep, goats, camels, horses. That's
from,
all.
From the Arabia.
From Makkah, Arabia, Arabian desert. So there are no cows. No buffaloes over there. There are only sheep and goats. And so to link it to the religion.
So the British brought it.
Of course, British eat beef eating, steaks. And it's not in the Arabian culture. So it cannot be linked to religion.
So is there a
available?
So is there a deliberate effort to stoke this trouble in the country?
I don't know. There are different kind of people. And I think that now that controversy is behind us, let's talk about future. Let's talk about our children. What do they want? They want do waqt ki roti, chahe dal se hi mile, do waqt ki roti to mile unko. Unko naukri chahiye, unko chhat chahiye.